Miss Frye, what a pleasant surprise.
Hello, Clara. I was just going to check on Lambeth since the asylum's closing. What brings you here?
The children in my care have been falling ill. Our usual tonics aren't working. A cane, too.
Are you certain you're feeling all right?
Of course. I am, miss.
Clara! Is there a doctor nearby?
Bring her inside. She simply collapsed?
Yes, she said the others took tonic, but it didn't work.
I should think not. Ever since Elliotson was murdered, the district has been overrun with counterfeit tonics. This one needs proper care. But without the appropriate medication, she and the others will quickly decline.
What do you need?
I need supplies. Plenty of them. And medicine. Some of the less common ingredients are being stolen and sold at auction.
I'd be happy to help.
Here's the list.
Miss Frye. E.V. Frye.
I'm Miss Nightingale. How do you do? Please hurry. We don't have much time.
That's it.
Thank you. we'll see what I can do.
Keep an eye on that one.
No one steals my armor out!
Enough. These supplies are meant for Miss Nightingale.
I'm here to collect them.
And they're already loaded on the cart. Please take them.
Giddy up!
You mean that cart?
Yes.
Of course it is.
Please be careful. Some of those items are fragile.
Not a moment too soon. I hope you brought the medication I requested.
How is she?
She will recover.
Papillonelli, the children.
Thanks to you, we can distribute authentic medicine now.
But is that a permanent solution?
I will petition to have regulations put in place.
Lambeth is in your debt.
It takes a long time to change things. But I'm not going anywhere, Miss Frye.
Huh.
In an effort to ensure so great a...
So the hints you found in the Kenway house lead to the monument.
What a wonderful use of your time, following me around asking obvious questions.
Well, since Henry isn't here, I thought you might enjoy the company.
I don't require any company, and Mr. Green is following up on some leads of his own.
Oh, yes, Mr. Green. That's a fascinating idea. Oh, please, Mr. Green, come and take a look at this book and stand oh so close to me, Mr. Green.
I do not. Well, perhaps you have nothing better to do, but I'm busy protecting the assassins.
Are you really? What was it Father used to say?
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission.
Precisely. Anyway, I'm off. If I find any more wild geese for you to chase, I'll be in touch.
Be ever more pleasant for your absence.
A tragedy will never happen again. I would like to thank our esteemed guests, the Right Honorable Premier Disraeli. Ensure that housing for the impoverished need not be a fire hazard.
Stop her!
We have heard your concerns. There is no need for shouting. Please. Tragedy will never happen again. I would like to thank our esteemed guests, the Right Honorable Premier Disraeli, members of Parliament, for being generous.
Please!
hope everything was to your satisfaction.
It's in the very top. The key to the vault, and the shroud.
Good day, Miss Frye. I'll take that.
You want shroud to cement your own power. But what if you cannot control it?
And why do you want the shroud? Merely to keep the Templars from having it? How like an assassin. To hold the power of eternal life, and yet be too afraid to use it.
Eternal life? Is that what you think the Shroud offers?
What I think is no longer your concern.
about to set out to fight the Blighters for the Territory.
The Rooks are in good standing with Miss Swinborne no longer leading the Thames Blighters. Good luck to both sides.
This borough belongs to us! This...
Guts you like a fish!
Jacob and Evie Fry. And as of this moment, you all work for us.
Of interest. Come back again, by all means.
Listen to me. I have been ordered to keep your rallies off the streets.
No, you must listen to me. The people in this city are in dire need of your assistance. Oh, you are Jacob Frye, are you not? And Miss Frye?
We're at a disadvantage, sir.
Karl Marx. Much like you, I am an activist of sorts.
You've got the look of a man who wants something.
Indeed. You've done more for London citizens lately than any endeavor has accomplished in a decade. But those citizens were already well provided for. I challenge you both to help those who really need your assistance, the working people.
An interesting challenge. We accept.
Shouldn't we at least talk about these things for... Sod it. We accept.
Organizing a discreet meeting with some like-minded friends to discuss trade unions. Alas, the police seem to have noticed my activities. They've stuck to me like flies on Scheisse.
In any case, I need you to help me get to the meeting without the interference of the police. You see? There's one of their young spies now.
Up to now.
This area is restricted.
Tonight, sundown, the usual place.
I'll be there.
You know, I had similar problems with the police in Paris. Well, Paris and Brussels. And also, perhaps Cologne. Our next worthy ally awaits us in a nearby pub. Onwards. No doubt the police already have agents stationed within. I'll wait here until the coast is clear.
I don't want it. This shot's mine! I can hear you! I can hear you! What in hell?
Location. 1 hour.
Right you are, Mr. Marx, sir.
Where's the look? Too bloody.
I see the little tight.
That's what.
I believe our work here is complete. Come, let's slip away and get to the meeting. I do appreciate your assistance in this matter. Only when workers are able to assemble freely and in strength will we be able to achieve the reforms we most assuredly deserve. Might I trouble you to stay nearby until the meeting is over? I fear we may yet meet with some mischief.
I told you, Marx will be here. Heard it from the man's own lips. Now about my payment.
You'll get your 30 pieces, chum. Don't you worry.
It seems the movement is ever doomed to be betrayed from within.
That's a girl.
The movement is ever doomed to be betrayed from within. Will you fetch the gentleman back?
You're being mistreated. You're frustrated with your lot in life. I don't want to die in a wrecked place such as this.
Hell, that's Marx's hired ruffian. Save me!
Surrender!
Chum!
Perhaps the movement is ever doomed to be betrayed from within. The movement is ever doomed to be betrayed.
And I might let you
Looks
live.
Like trouble.
Looks like bother to
it
me.
It would be wise to keep quiet.
My name is Sam.
Party not taken care of you?
Governor, at the mill scene, any man what joins a union will be put out of work come sunup. How long will the party feed my family for?
If we do not stand together, we are lost. My heart is broken, Simon. Please go. I thank you, my friend. I hope you will continue to aid the struggle when the opportunity presents itself.
A letter for me.
poor Dr. Elliotson came to a bad end. I do hope you cleaned up after yourself.